this very special series. CNBC TV 18 presents Haptic Customer First. COVID-19 is changing the way in which world works, and customer service has become more important than ever. From contactless engagement to personalization of customer engagement, COVID-19 is in fact accelerating some of the trends that already existed. In this special series, we are deep diving into customer service, customer experiences, digital transformation, AI, and much more. I'm Shivani Gharat, and today I'm joined by Manu Lavanya, who is the Chief Operating Officer of Max Life Insurance.
Thank you so much, Shivani. Thank you for having me. And such a fantastic topic, and what an opportune time to discuss this.
Manu, I would first like to begin by asking you, what does customer service mean to an organization like Max Life Insurance?
Great question, Shivani. And I'll start answering the question first from what business we are in, right? Life insurance is a business of trust. It's a business where the customer pays you today, signs up a contract today, and then they carry on this relationship with you over many, many years, with the hope that in the eventuality, when the policy matures, much in future, we keep the promise. So the first definition that Max Life, that we believe what customer obsession really means, is really keeping the promise. Are we keeping the promise to our customers? Right. Second, see, as a part of our values, four values of Max Life, customer obsession is one of the four values that Max Life culture is based upon. And when we say customer obsession, it simply means transforming the lives of our customers, making them more secure, making them more safe, and doing whatever it takes to keep our promise to our customers, right? Finally, when it comes to the experience piece of it, we look at ideas where how we can make the experience of our customers world-class, easy and simple as they transact with us through the entire relationship that we have with our customers, right from the first day of application of a policy down to the effective maturity or a claim and how that is processed. So end to end, how do we really take care of our customers end to end in their experiences, in the journeys, how easy it is for them, how simple is it for them, and how empowered they feel in that entire journey.
You know, Manu, I'm quite intrigued by your usage of the term customer obsession. Can you please elaborate on why are you using that term as an organization?
Great question, Shibani. And really, we believe that the erstwhile world of customer satisfaction, right, as a theme, always led to people achieving a certain threshold of performance, and then measuring and saying, hey, we are done. We have achieved this number. Originally, it was measured like a CSAT score. And you would say, hey, I met a score, right? The problem is, it's more cultural. It's more ingrained into how we behave every day in our transactions, in our strategy, in our decision making. Do we keep the customer first, right? And that needs a sense of obsession. That needs a sense of desire, which says that the value of customer obsession takes the highest priority whenever there's a trade-off between a customer need and an internal goal, for example, right? And to have that pure, unadulterated view of commitment to our customers, it requires that transformation from just seeking customer satisfaction to truly being obsessed to do the right thing for our customers.
In fact, we established right in the beginning how so much has changed around us because of the pandemic and COVID-19. Can you tell us how has your delivery of customer experience evolved or changed over the past few months?
It's been a very, very I would say learning last 16 months, 17 months, Shivani, as all of us saw this journey of this pandemic. And the first thing that this pandemic challenged in our business was, hey, how do we even start engaging with our customers? How do we even start reaching out? Because if you see insurance, life insurance, especially the front-end model, is a very people-driven model. It's a very, you know, human-to-human trust-based interaction model. So the first thing that technology came to rescue was, how do we transition the entire people-to-people, in-person, physical selling model into a completely digital model, where you use telepresence, where you use digital tools and skills to remotely access your prospects. That was the first big change that happened, that technology and digital brought in post the COVID world. The second challenge, Shivani, was that how do we make sure that when we onboard customers, we onboard the right profile of customers? There is a right type of evaluation of risk as we onboard our customers in the journey of insurance, right? And because the pandemic prevented us from being physically in front of customers, there had to be a way of the technology would use and machine learning would use and analytics would use to figure out how can I, let's say, prevent frauds, or how can I make sure that I make it easier for the customers to submit all the documents sitting at their home, and technology should be able to pick up those documents, read those documents, figure out the relevant information required for the backend policy issuance to work, right? So there is a lot of simplification that COVID has driven, first in the onboarding and the risk selection pieces of the process.
Manu, there has been a lot of anxiety over the past few months, you know, around us, including your customers. Can you tell us what has been the intersection between psychology and technology, and how have you interplayed between the two?
That's a fantastic question, Shivani, because normally people talk about the left brain part of it far extensively, which is technology. One transformation that I see that has happened over the with customers, I would say over the last almost 5 to 10 years, is that people are looking for a balance of functional gratification and emotional gratification, right? That's what the customers are looking for. And what that means is that when we look at the interplay of technology and consumer psychology, it's important to play, as I say, across the entire left brain, right brain continuum, right? Which means our solutions, our thinking, our interaction with the customers can't just be digital. At least in an insurance industry, I can say for sure that there are parts of the customer journey which require a significant amount of emotional connect. It requires a significant amount of empathy, right? God forbid if anybody, you know, our customers' families, actually, if they have to call upon the promise, right, in a very difficult situation, it requires a very emotional, a very empathetic response. Also, in these difficult times with COVID, even to collect premiums, to collect, the collected premium from our customers, it requires a great mix of automation, but also requires empathy. So what MaxLife has done is MaxLife has really, first of all, embarked upon a journey a couple of years ago on creating this industry-first model. We call it SDPL, Speed Dial Partner for Life. So normally, insurance is a very, very, she sees it as a very transactional sort of exercise, right? Hey, you meet your agent when you purchase a policy. You know, off the agent goes, 1 year later, a few days before the renewal premium, the agent calls you back and says, hey, sir, your policy is due. Make sure you make the payment. Can I sell something else to you? It becomes a fairly, fairly transactional sort of a relationship, right? And what we have done at MaxLife is we have put together this Speed Dial Partner for Life model, where if you send me an email, if you come through into a chatbot, if you call me up, if you go and WhatsApp me, I have one person assigned to me as a customer. I call it my Speed Dial Partner. You can call that person for any interaction that you need for MaxLife. Because what happens is, there is a left brain part of the process, Shivani, that works very well, which is, can I preempt what the customer is calling for? Can I make sure I can get self-help to the customer? The customer can know what premium is required, when it is required. So there is an efficiency part of the process that is addressed very well with automation, with AI, with technology. But then there is an emotional piece of it as well, which says, hey, you know what? I just lost my job last week. I'm not able to pay my premium. What options do I have? Now that conversation, it's a very different conversation. It requires deep empathy, deep connect, and doing the right thing for the customer, right? It is the ability for that bot to actually switch over to a human being seamlessly in the middle of the bot interaction and switch it over to the STPL, and where a human being can empathize and really take the process end to end. And hence, we strongly believe that both psychology and technology are equally important for a steady state world-class model of service for our customers. And that's how, with that intent, this phygital model of Speed Dial Partner for Life is built. So completely agree with your suggestion.
Before we go, Manu, customer expectation has changed over the past few years. What is it that you do to meet these high customer expectations?
Great question. And I'll try to divide, Shibani, the question in two parts. First, what has changed in the customer expectation over the last couple of decades? Right? And second, because of that change, what is Max Life changing? Right? So I'll try to answer it in two parts. See, if I were to say first, how has the customer service expectation evolved over the last decade? Right? There are four or five dimensions, and they'll be very, 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 very relevant. First, ease. I want my life easy. No, I don't want to fill five forms. I don't want to call five people. Just make my life easy. Send me someone to talk to at one shot, one place. If I can do it myself, the best, right? So the whole idea of ease. Second, don't make me a number in your base. Personalize your services and offerings to me. I'm not a number. I'm an individual. I have my own preferences. I have my own goals of savings, of protection in my life. I need you to cater your offers, your product, your services to who I am. I'll give you a small example. Our NPS survey sometimes, you know, a person would call and ask, hey, would you like to speak in English or Hindi? And the person would say, hey, do you think I can't speak English? That's why you're asking me. And the person would still go ahead and have the conversation in Hindi, right? Great example where people need personalization. Talk to me in the language I prefer. The third dimension is really, I want you on demand. I want instant gratification. I can't wait for my queries to be solved. Sorry, not tomorrow, not day after tomorrow. I want it now. Respond to me now. I need the information with me now. And then related to that is ubiquitous. I don't want to come to the branch every time. I want to experience your service. I want to experience your product wherever, whenever I choose to. In the switch from, as I said, functional gratification to functional and emotional gratification. I should feel happy when I interact to a Max Life agent. I should feel happy and empowered after I have interacted with a Max Life service agent, right? Those are very deep shifts from a very functional demand that existed in the past. And finally, yeah, I know you can solve my problem, but can you empathize with me, right? Can we be emotionally connected as well? And so these are the secular shifts that I have seen in the demand of customer service. Now, if I compare with our response, a big part of this response, Shibani, that Max Life has really driven is first around the whole, as I said, the omnichannel experience, that irrespective of where the customer comes in from, can I drive a consistent, simple, empowering journey to my customers? How does it happen? Significant investment happening on our front end. Significant investment happening in how we onboard our customers, our customer journeys, number of clicks. Instead of 10 clicks, can I have 3 clicks where somebody can onboard, get onboarded, right? Right from that detail down to the next level, which is, okay, what is the minimum information that I need from the customer to open a policy? Am I required to fill 60 fields and ask customer 5 forms? Or can I take all the information from the bank and, you know what, I'll fill in the only 2 or 3 required, right? So how does my interaction with my customer become super easy, super fluid, super, super simple? Then the third part is that when I look at how does my entire journey at the issuance become as responsive as possible? Can I cut down my time to my process times to make sure I can make the customer secure, contract in the customer's hand as soon as possible. There are projects that are being driven today, Shivani, in MaxLive, where a policy pack, from the time the entire documentation was done, decisioning was done in underwriting, it would still take 22 hours for the policy pack to ship out to the customers, right? Because of pure processes, pure technology. We are cutting that down to 6 minutes. The idea of insta issuance, can I commit that I can commit to a 30-minute issuance of an insurance policy consistently for a class of products and a wide variety of my customers? Can I ensure that I can do like insta pizza delivery? You have insta issuance where 30 minutes the policy is with you, right? So some of that all those transformation initiatives will be leveraging technology, AI to drive the response, very high responsiveness to the customers. And finally, how do I make sure that I'm there for my customers whichever time, whichever channel they choose to reach out to me, which is, am I accessible on WhatsApp, using bots, using emails, using a helpline, call in? I am available for my customers 24/7. So the whole idea of being ubiquitous, on demand, and being whenever, wherever my customers need me. So multiple projects, multiple initiatives around that automation. We've already done, already, you know, made progress. Very glad to share with you that if you look at self-help, that self-help number from about early 40% in terms of number of transactions that the customers could self-serve has actually increased to almost 75 to 80% in terms of number types of transactions that the customers can completely self-serve through a digital means. So significant improvements, significant investments going in automation for driving self-service for our customers. I hope that gives you a picture around all the initiatives that are driving this change or addressing the change of expectations from our customers.
That was Manu Lavanya telling us how there is always an interplay between emotion and technology when it comes to best serving your customer. Thank you so much for watching CNBC TV 18 presents Haptic Customer First. More such conversations will follow in the coming days. Goodbye.